tempted to be saying that we met by chance, but God was there at every turn, in every circumstance.
To share this life God gave me seems such a fearful task, but every moment we have shared
to live with Vita according to God's purpose? Do you promise to commit yourself to meeting her needs, physical, emotional, and spiritual? Do you promise that in whatever circumstances you will love, honor, respect, and sustain her, and that as long as you both shall live, you will be faithful to her? If so, answer, I will.
I will.
Vita, do you promise to live with Tim according to God's purpose? Do you promise to commit yourself to meeting his needs, physical, emotional, and spiritual? Do you promise that in whatever circumstances you will love, honor, respect, and sustain Tim, and that as long as you both shall live, you will be faithful to him? If so, answer, I will.
I will.
I like that. Now you will seal your vows by giving and receiving of rings. The ring is a material, a symbol that has been designed to illustrate a spiritual truth. A ring has two characteristics which make it suitable as a reminder to us of the importance of keeping Christ in our marriages. First, the ring is a circle. Circles never end. Christian marriages should never end. They should last and last forever. Difficult times will come, but the commitment of Christians is to make their marriages go on forever through Christ. The ring is a reminder that never-ending commitment. Also, rings are made out of precious metal, usually silver or gold, which has the unusual quality of getting better and more valuable with age. Instead of wearing out and deteriorating, we pray for your love to grow and improve with age. Tim, repeat after me. I, Tim, take thee, Vita.
I, Tim, take thee, Vita.
To be my wedded wife.
To be my wedded wife.
And to hold from this day forward.
And to hold from this day forward.
For better, for worse.
For better, for worse.
For richer or poor.
For richer. Or,
in sickness and in health.
In sickness and in health.
To love and respect.
To love and respect.
To cherish till death do us part.
To cherish till death do us part.
According to God's holy ordinance.
According to God's holy ordinance.
And with this ring.
And with this ring.
I pledge my love.
I pledge my love.
Vita, repeat after me, please. I, Vita.
I, Vita.
Take you, Tim.
Take you, Tim.
To be my wedded husband.
To be my wedded husband.
To have and to hold.
To have and to hold.
From this day forward.
From this day forward.
For better, for worse.
For better, for worse.
For richer, for poor.
For richer, for poor.
In sickness and in health.
In sickness and in health.
To love and respect.
To love and respect.
To cherish till death.
To cherish till death.
Do us part.
Do us part.
According to God's holy ordinance.
According to God's holy ordinance.
And with this ring. I pledge my love.
I pledge my love.
Tim and Vita, in these moments, I've heard you pledge your love and faith to each other. Your friends and family members assembled here have heard you seal your solemn vows of marriage by giving and receiving of rings. Let us pray. Bless, O Lord, the giving of these rings, that they who wear them may abide in thy peace and continue in thy favor through Jesus Christ our Lord. And Father, I pray a special blessing upon Tim and upon Vita and upon this marriage and upon all their children and upon their household and upon their family members. I thank you, Lord God, for a special anointing. I thank you, Lord God, Tim and Vita will be as an oasis. And I thank you, Father, as they are a man and woman of God. I thank you, Lord, that they are problem solvers. And I thank you, Lord, they will draw all men unto them from the highways and the byways. And I thank you, Lord, that they will have a strong family unit. I thank their family, Father, will follow them. I thank you, Lord, that they will have great wisdom of God, great knowledge and great understanding and great discernment. And be able to assist their children and give them answers. I thank you, Lord God, and give you all the precious glory for many years to come. That anointing that they walk in, and the closer they come to one another, and closer they come and to build a relationship together as one flesh in Christ, I thank you, Father, they grow stronger and stronger in the things of God and the anointing of God, assisting one another, assisting their family, and assisting their friends, and assisting all those throughout this world. And God, I give you all the precious glory. In Jesus' name I pray. At this time, the unity candle shall be lit, showing two separate lives, Tim and Vita, that once were apart, but now they have been united as one. Thank you.
Father, I said till death do us part. I want to mean it with all of my heart. Help me to love you more than I love her, than I know I can love her more than anyone else. And bring her in your presence today. Make her what you want her to be.
Said, first he said, bless this bread in the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. He said, take of me it often in remembrance of me. You may eat of the bread. And the Lord took the cup, and he blessed the contents in the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit, in the precious name of Jesus. And he said, drink. Do so often until my death, and until my return, in remembrance of me. You may drink of the cup.
Yeah.
we thank you for this blood covenant that Tim and Vita were partaking of for the first time in their lives. We thank you, Lord God, that you have blessed them, Father, with this union of marriage. We thank you, Lord God, that you ordained marriage, and it was your idea, and your idea for family. And Father, we thank you, as they partook today of the Lord's Last Supper, Lord, we give you all the glory and thank you for the special anointing that is upon them to succeed. And we thank you, Lord God, the anointing that they remember all the days of their life. The anointing is upon them, and it will always take them to the other side, no matter what the situation or circumstance they may come across their path. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Holy, righteous, and merciful Father, fill these servants of God, Tim and Vita, with a deep sense of solemn obligation to one another and to you, which they have just assumed. Guide them to look to thee for the grace in their sincere efforts to discharge these obligations with honor to themselves in the sight and in the sight of man. Ordain that their love now mutually pledged may never falter, whatever course life may take them, or where it may take them. Crown their lives with loving kindness and tender mercies, and provide them with protection while they travel the uneven ways that leads from now to the end. Lead them into the fullness of spiritual understanding and holy living, that they may have an abundant entrance into the joys of everlasting life. So we pray through Jesus Christ our Lord, in Jesus' name, amen. Tim, you may kiss the bride.
Woo, yeah. Do it again. Let me get a tight shot.